What times 100 would give me 4,500? Questions? Do the next one. Oh, not that 50%, that's too easy. Do number three, 90% of 600. 90% of 600, work that one. What'd you get?
540.
Okay, now 90% of 600, 540. Everybody get that?
Mm-hmm.
What'd you get? Did you do it? I think you confuse yourself. Why can't you just follow the steps? I mean, I don't see why that's so hard for you to just do exactly how we did it.
I forgot the steps.
That's why the board is there. Did you write is over of equals percent over 100? Did you write the thing on the of and the percent where it goes? I think you want it to be hard. Just put the numbers where they go. The 90 goes over 100, the of goes on the bottom. You're missing the top. So you're going to be multiplying 600 times 90. And then dividing by 100. Well, 600 times 90. Well, what's 600 times 90? And then, so 100 times what? Divide that by 100 to see what that answer has to be. And to divide by 100, I just said, move the decimal point back two places. When you move it back two places, what do you get? 540. Step by step. Do number four, 4.5% of 400. 4.5% of 400. 540. Yes.
90% of 600, I can't divide 100 into 540, it came up with 540 as a remainder.
It wasn't 540. You had 54,000 is what you told me.
Okay.
Divide that by 100, you won't come up with 5. It's distressing because you guys are making this much harder than it needs to be. Put the numbers where they go, okay? 90%, 90%, right? You got that part. Of 600. The steps are just multiply this times this and divided by that, right? This times this. That cannot be hard for you to do all these zeros. Right? Is that what you got? And you divided that by 100 and you only get 5?
Yeah, that's, I messed up on it.
Divided by 100, and that's why we teach you the fast way to do it, because you can mess up on it with all those zeros. That's why you don't put it in a box. You put the decimal point here and move it back two places, and that's divided by 100, and there's your 540 in 2 minutes or less.
You turn off of that, that's it.
Huh? The question was, what is 90% of 600? The answer is 540. You don't have to put it over anything. They just want the answer. The answer is that 540 is 90% of 600. Same way every time. I just don't understand it. It's no different if the numbers are big or small. You do it the same way. That one I just gave you said what, 4.5%? Write it like they say it. Don't matter it's a decimal. That's what it is. It goes over 100. Of what?
400.
Of 400. The of goes there. Setting it up should not be the problem. That's it. This times this, and you should be able to multiply decimals.
That times that divided by the...
Divided by 100. Now divided by 100. Just that simple. Just that fast. You always multiply the corners, divide by the other number, that gives you your missing number. Doesn't matter. They could have said 18 is what percent of 400? That could have been the problem. 18 is, because that's the is, right? What percent, that means I'm looking for the percent, but I know it's over 100, of 400, there's my of. Now I gotta multiply these two. And divide by this one. I should have gotten a 4.5. That's a 4. I had to change it. 4 times 4 is 16. I could have got this 4.5.
So 4.5 is the answer to that one?
To this one, 4.5. Or they could have said 18 is 4.5% of what number? They could have been looking for that. They can look for any of them. Right. I'm going to multiply these two. Divided by this one. You got to remember how to divide by a decimal.
So if you divide by the decimal, you just move the decimal over one.
You move it over as many times as you have to move it out there.
To get it to the end. That's whatever you do over here.
Right. Whatever I do out here, I do in there. I had to move it once there, I move it once there. If I had to move it twice there, I'd have to move it twice there. The thing is to get it to the end. Then I just divide. So I could have gotten the 400. You can find out any of them if you just put the things where they are, what it says. If it says this is, then you have the is. What percent? I know I'm looking for the percent. Of this number, there's my of. If they say what is, I know I'm looking for the is. Then they'd have to give me the percent. I know it's over 100. and they'd have to give me the of. Or if they say, this is this percent of what, I'm looking for the of. And I know I'm gonna have two of them diagonally that I'm gonna multiply, and I'm gonna divide by the other number that's there, and the answer is the missing number. The answer will be the answer to the question. You just have to make sure that you put the things in the right place. Make sure you understand what is the is, what is the of. The percent always will have the word percent with it, so that's easy. You just have to figure out what is your part and what is your of. What is your is, what is your of. But what you have to remember, keep it in mind, that the is the part. If it's less than 100%, the part's got to be smaller than the whole. Because if the part is the same as the whole, you have all of them. You have 100%. If the part is more than the whole, you have more than 100%. Most questions will not be more than 100%. So if you're in doubt, the smaller number is probably the part. The bigger number is probably the whole. Because we're talking about a portion of that whole is the percent of that whole. So we're talking about the part of the whole, which is going to be smaller. The part is going to be smaller than the whole. But you should be able to figure out what is the is, what is the of. But you have to memorize that is over of equals percent over 100. You can't just say it and forget it. That's what you have to memorize, because that's what